In this video, we're talking about three ways that you can use Microsoft Forms at work. This applies to you whether you're working at a corporate job or you're running your own business. Here's the thing, to be successful at what you do, you are going to need some information, right? Some data. This could be information about your customers. It could be about your team or about your employees. You need a structured way of collecting this information so you can analyze it a lot quicker and decide on your next steps. Microsoft Forms helps you with that. Plus, it recently got some really cool updates that you might have missed. I'm going to cover them as I cover the three ways that you can use Forms in your business. Right now, you might be wondering, is Microsoft Forms suited for collecting data from people outside the organization? Because we know how Microsoft products can be when it comes to sharing files with externals. With Forms, you don't need to worry about that. You can easily share with externals. Another question you might have is, do I need a paid Microsoft account? You don't. There is a free version of Forms you can use with your free Microsoft account, but you are limited in the number of responses you can receive. If you have a Business 365 account or an education account, you can receive up to 5 million responses for a single survey, which is amazing. You can extract the data in a CSV file and analyze it as you need in Power BI or Excel. Well, you'll be using Power Query as your entry point if you have that much data. Okay, so the first form you can use is surveys. Now, creating a survey from scratch is super easy. You just have to open up your browser and navigate to forms.office.com, log into your account, and click on New Form. This starts off the process, but you don't need to start from scratch. You can explore existing templates. Click on View All to see the different templates available by category. Right, so surveys can be used for different purposes. You can use them for internal business purposes like employee satisfaction survey, collecting feedback on your project, or maybe you're planning a team event and you want feedback on that. You can also share surveys externally, for example, with your customers to get feedback about a product you created. To take a look at what a survey looks like, let's go with employee satisfaction survey. Now here we get a nice background cover. We have a good title, but guess what? We also get pre-populated questions and answers. How cool is that? You can, of course, click on each question and adjust it as you need. AI also gives you some additional options if it thinks that might be suitable for this question. So for example, neutral might make sense here. You can add your own options by clicking on the plus. You can adjust the answers, delete the answers, update it as you need. The best part is you already have something to work with, so the entire process could be a lot faster. You also get recommended questions. So let's say you want to grab their phone number or this question, were colleagues welcoming when you started? I'm just going to click on these and add them in. They're right here. You can, of course, add your own questions as well. So let's say, which day of the week is your favorite? Notice the moment I type day of the week, AI kicked in and is suggesting these. I'm going to add them all. And then let's remove the ones I don't want to show up in the response. Now, another place AI is at work is under style. These styles are suggested based on the topic here. So we get this more corporate styles because this is an employee satisfaction survey. If I change this to birthday party, notice these are changing here. I get different options. I'm just going to press Ctrl Z a few times and go back. You have more style options here. Under View All, you can adjust the color and change the layout as you see fit. And if you're up for it, you can add some background music as well. You have some choices, like this one here. Right? It's more funky. I'm just going to turn it off for now. Personally, I don't think I'm going to be creating surveys with background music. Let's go to Settings and see what other options we have available. So here under More Options, we're going to go to Settings. We can decide who can fill out the form. If you're sharing this with externals, you would go with Anyone Can Respond. This is not an external survey though, so I'm going to go with Only People in My Organization Can Respond. You can decide if you want to record the name or not. You can also add a start date and an end date to your survey. I'll just go with end date of end of May. Then you have some other options like customizing your thank you message and so on. Now, in addition to this, you also have this other AI option. So anywhere where you come across this lightning icon, it means that it's an AI feature. When I click on this, it tells me add description, share a description of your form to encourage responses. I'm going to click on add, and it added this in. It says, would you mind taking 2 minutes to complete this form? The amount of time is estimated by the AI. It also added the end date to this. Now let's say I'm ready to share the survey with others. I can start collecting responses, double check your settings here to see if it's correct. You can copy the URL link. You can also shorten the link before you copy it, or you can directly share this in Outlook or in Teams. Just type in the name of the chat or the group, and you're going to see it here. Your other options for sharing is to use the QR code here or to embed this form on a website. Now, how about when it comes to reviewing the data that you receive? Well, there are also some AI features for that. I'm just going to go and open up another form I've already created that already has some responses. So here's a form that already has over 1,000 responses. When I go to view the responses, notice on some of these responses, I have insights. When I click on this, I get some patterns that it's picked up. For example, here, 81% of people answered were men to this question, and the majority answered high for question one. I have the ability to pin this as well if I want to. Okay, so this is a quick overview about how you can create surveys, which are super helpful for collecting information. The next form type you can use at work are quizzes. Some business use cases for these are, let's say you're training your team on how to use a new tool and you want to make sure that they understood all the important bits. An external use case for it is, for example, you're recruiting for a new position and you want to test the candidate's knowledge. And sometimes these tests need to be timed, right? You want to see how they perform under pressure. You can do that with Microsoft Forms. You can create timed quizzes. Now, setting up a new quiz is super easy as well. You just have to click on New Quiz. If you've already written out your quiz in Microsoft Word, use Quick Import and it's going to convert it into a form. I'm going to go with New Quiz here and let's put in a title, Power BI Assessment for the Data Analyst Position. So let's say I want to share this quiz externally. I'm interviewing people for a new position and I want to give them a test to see if they're the right fit. Let's add a text field. I'm going to go with name. This is a required field, and they're going to get 0 points for adding their name. Next one is a choice. I'm going to go with a multiple choice question. Now check this out. You can upload the image from your OneDrive or from your device, or you can just drag and drop it here. Let's say I have an image saved on my desktop. I'm just going to drag and drop it, and it's immediately going to add it to my quiz. Then I just have to select which one is the right answer. I'm just going to click on this and add in the points. So I'll go with 5 points here. Now, where can you set the timer? You can do that in settings. So go to more options here under settings, scroll down and you can set a time duration. So this is 30 minutes. I'm going to go with 15. What happens when the time is over? Well, we have the information here. Editing is not allowed after the timer ends, and the answers are going to be automatically submitted once the timer is up. Once you've set up the quiz as you need, you can switch this option to anyone can respond, especially in this case because I'm planning to share this externally. And then I just need to go and copy the URL and share this publicly if I want to. How does everything look on the back end? So what happens when the responses come in? So here I have a more elaborate form that already has 2 responses. Let's go and see how this looks. I can get a quick overview here. And to see each response, I can review the answers. This shows me the answers one by one. So this is the first person. That's the second person. Here I have a correct answer. These text fields need review. So I have to put in the score myself. So let's say I'm happy with this. I'm going to put a 5. This is correct, needs review. I could go with a 0 here, and so on. Now, another great feature is that you can compare people's answers with one another. So if you switch your view from people to questions, you get to review the questions one by one. This is especially helpful for text answers. So here, no answer was provided, and this one was just a text answer. Here I can see the first one that I already gave the points to, and this one is similar, so I'm going to give them 5 points as well. Okay, so that's a quick look at quizzes and how you can use it in your business. The third method of gathering information is through polls. Polls are typically used in the Teams app, and they're great for collecting feedback right inside the app. You can use it in chat, and you can use it in posts and also during meetings. It's a great way of getting people involved and engaged during your meetings. To add a new poll to your Teams chat or to a channel, click on New Conversation. If you don't see polls here, click on More Options, and you might see it here. That's the one we're looking for. If you still don't see it, go to More Apps and search for polls here. Now I'm just going to select it, and it's immediately going to bring up this pop-up where I can put in my question. Let's just add these answers. You have the ability to record the names of the respondents and share the aggregated results with them if you want to. If you don't want to share, just click on this and it's going to hide the answers. I'm going to go with sharing for this one. Click on preview. This looks good. Let's send this. It's going to add it to the Teams channel. Now, because I'm sharing the results, the moment people start to submit their votes, we are all able to see the answers here. Now, if you're wondering, what is this forms option? Because when you click it, it looks very similar to polls. Well, Microsoft published an article about this where they state that polls will replace the Forms app in Teams. Do you need to be worried about your previous responses where you use the Forms app? No, you don't. Your polls and response data in the Forms app are going to be automatically synced to the Polls app. Well, what happens to the Forms app? Well, eventually it's going to be dedicated to providing an improved survey experience across Teams. So to wrap up, ultimately you get one app, which is Microsoft Forms, and you get to use it to collect data for different business purposes. Surveys was one to help us check how things are going and to decide our next steps. Quizzes can be used for recruitment purposes and also for in-house training. And polls are perfect for real-time actionable feedback. I hope you found this video useful. Now, I want to know, what will be the next form that you create? Comment below and just type in survey, quiz, or poll, depending on what you're planning to create next. Thank you for stopping by and watching this video all the way to the end, and I hope to see you in my next video.